In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make a cinematic 3D text effect inside DaVinci Resolve. So let's get right into it. So I've already got a timeline open and a 10-second B-roll waiting, and the first thing we gotta do is come to the effects and drag and drop a fusion composition into the timeline. And for this effect, I'm gonna make this comp 4 seconds long. Now we'll head over straight to fusion, and as you can see, we've only got a media out node. So first, we gotta drag and drop a background into the node tree, and this is gonna be a kind of a ground plane for us. So let's connect it to the media out, and we're gonna make it an alpha background. Now actually for this effect, you won't need a 3D text node. All you have to do is drag and drop this regular text node into the node tree, like this. And now we're gonna connect the output of our text node into the output of our background node, and a merge node will appear. And make sure the text is in the foreground, or this green arrow right here. Now we're gonna write our text. Let's change the font to something nicer, and increase the size a little bit. Now we're gonna right-click in the text box, and we're gonna find the follower option. And what this does is it's gonna make all of our animations happen in a continuous way. So now we're gonna go to modifiers and change the order from automatic to random but one by one. And the delay we're gonna change from 0 to 2.0. Now we're gonna come to shading. And the first thing we're gonna animate is the rotation. So let's scroll down, find the rotation right here. And making sure we're at the beginning of the animation, we're gonna set a keyframe on the Z wheel. Now we're gonna slide it to the left a little bit, like this is fine. Now we're gonna come to, let's say, frame 36 and type in 0. And now we can see a slight rotation happening. Next, we're gonna come to the spline tool, select the angle Z, click on this button right here so we can see both keyframes, select the two of them, and hit F on the keyboard. And that's gonna smooth out our animation. Let's close the spline. Next, we're gonna animate the softness. So let's go back to frame 0, hit a keyframe on the X and Y axis of the softness, and move the sliders all the way up, so the text gets practically invisible. Let's go back to frame 36, and bring the sliders all the way down. Let's go to the spline again, uncheck the angle Z, hit the zoom to fit again, select both keyframes, and hit F again on the keyboard. Close the spline. Now for the last animation, we're gonna mess around with the position. So here on frame 36, we're gonna set a keyframe on the offset Z. And going back to frame 0, we're gonna type in minus 10. And as you can see, the text disappeared. And what we just did was to make the animation happen as if the text is flying through the camera. So let's go to the spline again, uncheck softness X and Y, hit the zoom to fit, select both keyframes, and hit F. Close the spline. Now let's go back to the edit page, and let's see how it goes. Once our animation in is done, we're gonna now make our animation out. And for that, all we have to do is hit Option or Alt on the keyboard, left-click our fusion comp, and drag it to the right, like this. Now, we right-click our second fusion comp, and create a new compound clip. Next, making sure our compound clip is selected, we're gonna hit R on the keyboard, and right here on the speed, we're gonna type minus 100, and that's gonna make the animation happen in reverse. And now, let's see how it goes. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel, and if you want to learn another cool text effect inside DaVinci Resolve, make sure to check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.